Hello, welcome to Tech Talks again. Today I have Vivian Nwakah, the CEO and founder of Medsaf. Medsaf is a platform that helps pharmacies, local hospitals, in terms of managing their drug supply. Vivian.
Yes.
Welcome to Tech Talks.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
So how old is Medsaf? Why did you get into Medsaf? What's your background then?
Very interesting story. Medsaf launched in January of 2017. My background, I was born and raised in the US, so grew up there, started home healthcare agencies that scaled across Illinois and Indiana. Decided to go to business school and wanted to travel too, so went to school at the Sorbonne in Paris and the Federal University of Rio in Brazil. And we went to Peking University in China. And it just opened my eyes to emerging markets. So I was getting quite excited. And of course, as I'm traveling all over the world, I'm thinking, why haven't I been or given anything to Nigeria, as I'm Nigerian? So I came here for 3 months to do an internship, and I've been here for 5 years.
Since then?
Since then. So I have actually not left. I have not been back to Chicago to live since then. But one of the things that really struck me is that in my first 2 months, one of my friends died from taking a fake malaria pill. So now here I am doing my internship and I'm contrasting and comparing the US healthcare system, which I know very well, and now my own experiences in Nigeria and also the stories. And every single person that I know that I've spoke to has some story about someone they know impacted by medication, whether it's fake or substandard. And so that just inspired me. I called manufacturers from around the world and I asked them, why aren't you supplying your medications in Nigeria? And they'd say, lack of transparency, we can't protect our brand. So then I talked to hospitals and pharmacies and they would say, we're working with so many different distributors, there's so many different ways that we get medications, we can't find certain medications, and everyone had a different understanding or a different competency as it pertains to procuring medications. And so we're inspired by a lot of the tech companies that were disrupting markets and said, why not build a platform that can actually make this entire process, the supply chain, much easier, smoother for all of the various stakeholders and focus on giving hospitals and pharmacies the support they need using technology. So they purchase and they manage their medications with Medsaf.
So if I was, for example, a local hospital clinic, how would I access Medsaf?
Yeah, it's very simple. We wanted to make every technology as simple to use as, you know, Jumia or Facebook or Instagram. So if you're a hospital, you just simply go to www.medsaf.com. You sign up, we verify you, and you can fill up your basket.
How do you verify?
So we'll call, have a team of pharmacists that will call, we'll verify the facility and make sure you're real and that you're known to the government as a registered hospital or pharmacy. And at that point, you can purchase whatever medications you see on our platform. You can see all the prices. We even go above and beyond because you can see all the information about the medication as well.
How do you get to the hospital?
Yeah, so we vet manufacturers. So we look at...
Once I'm a local hospital, I buy, then is it DHL or is it...
Yeah, so we have built a drug procurement ecosystem. So we work with providers who have really good service. So if an order comes to us, we now work with all of our vetted manufacturers, make sure we have their products packaged. We do quality control checks and balances, package their medication, and then we would hand it off to one of our preferred or logistics partners who can then get it directly to the door of the hospital.
How did you get your suppliers to trust
this
Nigerian company? Because sometimes it's just about trust.
Absolutely. So it was just about selling the big vision, right? Manufacturers are also struggling. They have to get their medications. Especially the tier ones, what you were talking about, your Mercks, your Pfizers, your Sanofis, they spent how much money in research and development? and making sure that their medication is of a certain standard. And so when it gets to countries like Nigeria and then it gets repackaged and faked and sold and all those things, they lose control of their brand. So, and then you've got like a local, also the local manufacturers. There are great local manufacturers who are working really, really hard to provide medications, safe and good quality medications in Nigeria, but they also have a lot of costs. So detailing and going to every single hospital and trying to tell everybody, it's a lot of money. So Medsaf is a way for them to be able to actually reach the decision makers without having to invest, you know, thousands and thousands of dollars on detailing and, you know, trying to get the word out about their medication.
So, I mean, and that's very interesting as well, because you're also helping improve the standards. So if you're local and you want to get on a platform, there's a minimum requirement.
Yes. Medsaf is the trusted source to purchase and manage your medications. And we want to be a stamp of approval on where medications are coming from.
So, you started in 2017, early 2017. What are the numbers like in terms of supplies, in terms of hospitals? Are you where you want to be and where are you going to?
So right now, we're about to launch our fundraising because we have an opportunity to really just get into over 2,000 hospitals and pharmacies across Nigeria. We have a Francophone Africa deal that's coming up that's 20 countries. We have a Ghana, like we have a lot. So what we need is help. So we'd be happy for Diamond Bank to also, you know, just partner with us on this.
Well, we can definitely explore that offline. Yeah. We can't be telling people too many things on camera.
But yeah, we have a lot of demand. We have a really small team. We use technology to just kind of really reduce, you know, the amount of bodies. So for example, we're running data analytics on, you know, preempting our own demand, preempting the demand of our hospitals and pharmacies, you know, so that we can spread out our time and you know, be able to work with a small team. And so we're expanding now our team, but we're just trying to do that in tandem with technology so that we have, you know, very balanced growth and can control the quality of the experience.
So I think you answered the question indirectly. So how do you do your marketing? How do you create awareness for myself, especially on with the pharmacies and the hospitals?
Right now, it's just been word of mouth, referrals. We've spoken at some of the organizations, but honestly, we haven't done any marketing. We just launched, and it was word of mouth and the people who took us on as our first clients that just continue to help us spread the word and validate Medsaf. So we have not run a marketing campaign. The most that we'll do is update on LinkedIn or Instagram or Facebook. That's it.
So when you talk about local hospitals and pharmacies, how big do you have to be? What's the minimum standard or criteria? Because
so major 75% of all hospitals and pharmacies in the country are run by single owners. So these are doctor, maybe family, and the mom's the nurse, or the kids work there, and they literally have a lot of work to do, right, to give good patient care. So Medsaf is a benefit to them that can really help them in so many different ways. We are the first distributor to create a financial product for hospitals and pharmacies to purchase and manage their medications. We have created an ecosystem that makes their lives easier. We have supplied the Reddingtons, but we're more for the small, mid-sized hospital, clinic, and pharmacy that really needs the support of managing the quality, the cost, and the availability of their medications.
Last question. What's the gendered numbers when it comes to the pharmacies? The pharmacies at the local hospitals, are there more male doctors or is it balanced?
It's very balanced. Yeah. I mean, I'd say some of our really great hospitals are run by women. I mean, it's balanced. I see the medical industry in Nigeria from the single owner perspective. I see it as really kind of spread across the board. We meet many, you know, many women who are running hospitals. In fact, our first client, Paleon, which is just down the street, is run by Dr. Onya. She's an amazing visionary woman that decided to give us our first shot. So, you know, it's a lot of women. So I don't have a number, but I'm sure men run a lot.
Of course, and women too.
Yeah.
Vivian, thank you very much for coming on Tech Talks.
Thank you.
And we'll conclude the conversation offline.
Awesome.